To recap the last video, I'm showing here the five city graph, which shows the positive correlation between the 2018 local election results won by the KMT by approximately 10% and the 2020 presidential election results, which showed a huge increase of support for the DPP, which should have resulted in a negative correlation between the two sides. But we do see here a positive correlation, which proves that there was election fraud. These five cities are made up of approximately 58% of the registered voters in Taiwan: New Taipei City, Taizong, Kaohsiung, Taoyuan, and Tainan. And you can also see a positive correlation in each one of these cities too. To remind viewers, a positive correlation in this particular case comparing 2018 and 2020 should result in a negative correlation if it was normal voting behavior. A positive correlation would suggest widespread election fraud. In 2018, the DPP lost the election by approximately 10% nationwide. In 2020, the DPP won the election by 18.52%. Such a large swing in support rate for the DPP would surely result in a negative correlation between the KMT and the DPP. Public opinion polls done by the mainstream media in Taiwan had Tsai ahead by 20 to 30 points or so. When the results came out, she won with a 57.13% to 38.61% margin, an advantage of 18.52%, which is nearly 20 points. Therefore, the official results seem to match with the public opinion polls. If the opinion polls were real, the correlation in the above graphs would be negative. Instead, they are positive. These are the weighted results of the 2018 election, with the independent ballots distributed 54.92% to the KMT and 45.07% to the DPP. The ratio of 54.92 and 45.07 was determined by the ballots received nationwide officially for the KMT and the DPP. So the weighted results, including the independent ballots, for the KMT were 6.54 million, for the DPP 5.35 million, and 608,590 ballots reserved for PFP candidate James Song. Also, Miaoli County independent candidate Xu Dingzhen was counted as DPP as a part of its base total. Since there was no official DPP candidate in the area, the DPP backed this independent candidate. How do we determine which side was cheating and which side was being cheated? The graphs confirm one side was cheating by stuffing ballots and stealing ballots from the other side at the same time. But which side was rigging the vote? In 2018, the percentage breakdown was KMT 54.92% and DPP 45.07%. Determining the percentage between the KMT and the DPP in the official 2020 results: Taiwan received 8.17 million, Hankoui received 5.52. From the total of 13.69 million ballots, we can see the DPP received 59.67% of the vote, and the KMT received 40.33% of the vote. This is, of course, excluding the ballots for PFP candidate James Song, as we are trying to determine the ratio between DPP and KMT. The Central Election Commission is claiming that DPP support went from 45.07% to 59.67%, and that KMT support went from 54.92% to 40.33%. Increase in DPP support claimed by the CEC is 32.3%. Decrease in KMT support claimed by the CEC is 26.56%. Therefore, the correlation should clearly be negative. As we have seen already, the five cities from 2018 to 2020 show a positive correlation between the KMT and DPP party, and also show a positive correlation in each individual city. Therefore, we can conclude that the 2020 election results were rigged because the correlation was positive. This also proves the public opinion polls done by the media were also faked. The following news report quotes opinion polls with Tsai ahead by 20 to 30 points. TVBS Poll Center: Tsai 45%, Han 29%, Song 7%. The news report suggests that despite the large turnout at Han's rallies, he is still far behind in the polls. The media attempted to suggest that rally turnout and opinion polls have no correlation with each other.
韩国瑜的造势场总被支持者挤得满满满，走到哪都有坚定不移的粉丝紧追。这样热乎乎的明星始终没能呈现在民调数据。2020总统大选封关民调，根据 TVBS 资料显示，英德配支持度有45%，领先国政配的29%，余湘配支持度则是7%。
These false polls also attempted to attribute the larger turnout to an overwhelming increase in first-time voters. It was, in fact, really just ballot stuffing. It was observed by people on both sides that the wait time for the election was considerably shorter.And there was not many people voting in this election. The voter turnout was exaggerated due to ballot stuffing and did not match with what people observed in the voting stations.
从年龄层进一步分析，20到39岁两个族群，蔡英文都获得超过50%支持，韩国瑜则不到25%。40到49岁双方支持度才拉近，蔡英文约40%，韩国瑜约30%。更高的年龄层，韩国瑜依旧落后蔡英文。
The Taiwanese Public Opinion Foundation.Gave the results of Tsai 52.5%, Han 21.9%, Song 9.5%. The predicted ballot difference by the TPOF was over 3.08 million for Tsai Ing-wen. And former DPP legislator Shen Fu-shung predicted a 3 million ballot victory or more for Tsai Ing-wen. He also predicted the number of seats the KMT and DPP would win in the legislative re-en.
周立伦的防线会被攻破，退守到朱立伦防线之外，这个意思是说，韩国瑜有可能输超过308万票。
台湾民意基金会公布民调，英德配的支持度有52.5%，领先国政配的21.9%，与余湘配的9.5%，还有大约10%的民众还不知道投给谁。前立委沈富雄也在网络大胆预测选情。沈富雄列出表格，预测蔡英文的得票数将会赢韩国瑜大约300万票。立委席次，民进党增加到66席，国民党跌到38席。
Despite the polls, Han continued to draw large crowds even when it was raining.
但这评估许多网友不认同，认为好像是在刺激民众，要风雨无阻去投韩国瑜。这样的气势在多次活动就已经证明，就算天气再冷，雨下得再大，支持者就是苦苦等候，只希望看到韩国瑜一眼。理性的数据分析对决感性的造势人潮，谁输谁赢就在投票日见真章。
Let's look at the official 2018 Tainan results. The DPP got 367,518 ballots. The KMT 312,874 ballots. Independent candidates totaled.286,278 ballots. To determine the weighted totals for Tainan in 2018, I added 54.92% for KMT and 45.07% for DPP from the independent candidates' ballots. The weighted total for the DPP was 478,056 ballots and for the KMT, 447,539 ballots.Therefore, the DPP got approximately 51.65% of the vote, and the KMT got 48.35% of the vote in Tainan. The official 2020 results for Tsai in Tainan were 786,471, and for Han, 339,702 ballots. So the percentage breakdown was 69.84% for Tsai Ing-wen and 30.16% for Han Kuo-yu.This was excluding PFP candidate James Song's ballots, since our goal is to determine the percentage breakdown between the KMT and DPP. Therefore, the DPP increased their support rate by 32.8%, and the KMT decreased their support rate by 37.6%. This would clearly result in a negative correlation. We have already determined that the opinion polls were falsified because from 2018 to 2020, the correlation was positive. According to the Central Election Commission results from 2018 to 2020, the DPP support increased around 32.8% from our weighted estimation of DPP support from 2018. However,Does this assertion match up with rally turnout in the months leading up to the election? Let's take a look at a DPP rally in Tainan from January 5th, 2020. Throughout TTV's broadcast, the back portion of the rally wasn't shown for the audience to see.
I get time, man. Say, I get time. Ten number, get time.
Do you shall have a chipper, chipper, make a young boy die? Don't we help you see the
same thing?
Why, yes, boy?
You're sending me
out. Why,
yes, boy?
Near the end of the rally, only the seats near the front were shown to make the crowd look full. In contrast to TTV's live broadcast, we will now see the full picture of this rally on CTI station. Keep in mind that Tsai ended up receiving 67.4% of the vote in Tainan only 6 days later on January 11th and increased DPP support in the city by around 32.8%.
第二个，在讲台南造势大会哈。 我们现在看到的这个左边中间的这个开矿的这个影片，我就问一句话，因为我相信今天到了现在已经晚上八点了，很多的网友、很多的观众朋友都已经看到了这个造势大会的影片了。这个影片，Tour
buses are evidence that people were sent by bus to the rally. Leaving the rally early is not something real fans of the presidential candidate would do. Leaving early means that the people were scheduled to go home at that time. And they left early because they were most likely from out of town.
我只问一句话哈，因为他有三段影片，我三段全部都看了。第一段是蔡总统还在讲话的时候，前面的半场还有看到人，可是后来后面的半场部分呢，人已经变少了。但是呢，你可以看到蔡英文总统在台上的时候，我给大家看一下这影片哈。他整个影片在进行过程当中，你可以看到蔡英文总统他还在台上的时候，有没有？
哎呀，这个是。
在蔡英文，这个时候蔡英文还在台上，但是你可以看到，这里已经前半场，因为他分前后两个半场，跟台中的那个大场大概可以比拟，这里大概就剩下七八成左右而已。继续往后看，后面根本没有人了。好，我把它定格，你大家注意看哈。 这边的红色的塑胶椅都是空空的，人后半场基本上只剩下10%左右而已。可是下一个我要告诉你，就是当蔡总统致辞，蔡总统呼口号到蔡总统去后面跟大家握手的时候，人变更少，他变得连很快的速度哦。我现在马上开地方给你们给大家看，他很快的速度，那些椅子基本上直接就收掉了，直接把椅子全部收光。
所以总统还在讲话，下面都在修衣啊的地方。
来，再给大家看，再给大家看第二个哈，这个是刚刚那个之后大概过了大概三分钟左右，又变成这样的状况。好，他在喊王定宇当选了，大家可以回去对哈，当成这边在喊王定宇当选的时候是什么时候？哇，
根本只剩前面有人了。
我给大家看哦，因为等一下我会给大家看其他的影片，就当你那一天的所有直播跟媒体报道的时候，它都是拍前面这一部分。 好，那在台南术语叫做萨库拉，就是说前面看起来是很多人，可是后面的部分你不会看到，然后大家继续看，我刚刚所讲的，在刚刚给大家看的第一个影片的时候，那一些红色的塑胶椅是散布在整个的会场，有没有？好，你看现在片过来了，我等下定格给大家看。来，你注意看有没有？还没结束，这里的椅子已经没有人了，但是很多都是变一个了，你有没有看到这里？它叠起来了，对不对？对，十个叠一个，准备要收上卡车了。 人还在台上，不但人走光了，连塑胶椅都踏破了。
王哥拍谁？我唱个话。最后那个，应该是大家最情绪激动、最沸腾的时候吧。结果他是人最少的时候。
好，所以有图有真相，有因有感觉。观众朋友，我只要讲一件事情，因为我在今天早上看到这个影片之前，我也不知道原来所谓号称15万人的这个造势大会，到后来我必须要讲清楚，我们不能够污蔑说，哎，从头到尾都人那么少，一定有人多的时候。可是当蔡总统还在台上。 当所有人还在呼口号的时候，下面已经走成这样，这也是事实。如果没有现在这个在高处往下拍的网友，他所拍出的这样的状况，你根本不会知道。昨天所有的媒体都没有告诉你，但是蔡总统跟赖清德他们站在舞台上，他有看到，他会知道。那我现在的结论很简单哦，这个场地很大，所以他确实是一个大型的造势大会。蔡英文总统跟副总统候选人赖清德都到了，不要忘记这里是台南，赖清德是赖神，他是前台南市长，黄伟哲也到了。六个民进党的立委，现在有五位，全部都是民进党。这样的本命区跟主场，没有下雨，地上没有烂泥巴，也不是晚上十点，但台中的人不理亏，台南人却已经遭料料，这就是最大的差别。如果没有这个影片出来，谁会知道台南居然是这样？特别是台南。所以今天哦，这些三段不同的影片，从蔡总统讲话、蔡总统跟赖清德呼口号，到后来再喊王定宇动算的这三段。台上都还是这些大咖的同时，台下已经全部几乎都走光，这会是一个很严重的情绪。
我想问你，你新闻做那么久了，那为什么我们的媒体都不把真相告诉我们的民众？
老师，我觉得两点哈，第一个就是说，因为蔡英文总统一直都说，因为他是总统，所以不可以有空拍机，所以如果早早出空拍机，就可以看到是这样。第二个就是说，现场采访的媒体他可能有两种状况，第一个是。他可能媒体关系很好，所以他没有报道。第二个就是他可能媒体出动人没有那么多，所以他没有到高点去看，他只有在舞台前面往上拍，这有可能不知道。
It should be noted that in the DPP rally in Tainan on January 5th, that there were no weather issues. It was a sunny day and there was no rain, but people left either before or while Tsai was speaking on stage. Needless to say,The end of the rally is the most important part as the presidential candidate is the climax. This is further evidence that Tsai's actual support rate was not as high as the polls claimed, but was actually low.
但是我还是那句话，如果没有这一个影片，那根本不会知道原来在最绿最绿的台南，现在看起来蔡英文总统他的人气没有想象中那么高。我还是那个主轴，大家要记得，不是从头到尾都没人在骗你，
对，
而是说这些群众。明明天都还没有黑，已经急着要走，这件事情非常值得观察。
蔡英文不是说吗？他说：“哎呀，每一次台南我们都是全雷打呀，全部的立委，台南所有的立委都是民进党。结果做一个所谓号称十万人或十五万人的大造势，风和日丽，没有风，没有雨，天气这么好，然后却是这样的一个场面。”
In contrast.At Han rallies, people stayed late for Han Kuo-yu to appear and speak. People were willing to sit through rain to listen to him speak during the campaign.
但这评估许多网友不认同，认为好像是在刺激民众，要风雨无阻去投韩国瑜。这样的气势在多次活动就已经证明，就算天气再冷，雨下得再大，支持者就是苦苦等候，只希望看到韩国瑜一眼。理性的数据分析对决感性的造势人潮，谁输谁赢就在投票日见真章。
Now we can clearly see that the atmosphere and attitude of the public was clearly different in the days leading up to the election. We have concluded here that the correlation between 2018 and 2020 should have been negative, but it was positive.The positive correlation proves that the opinion polls quoted by the mainstream media were clearly false. No credible polling center would declare a result that was off by that much unless they were deliberately faking the results. The poll results have essentially been reversed and given to the Taiwan public and the entire world to mislead everyone about the true support rate in Taiwan. Dear Central Election Commission, I'm still waiting for your response.